guys. The moment you guys have all been waiting for, the long anticipation wait is over. And the lack of me having a chance to do race and crashing, having to do it again on a new Chicagoland track, is finally here and ready to go, finally to start the chase for the Mountain Race Series Season 4. Hello guys and welcome here to the chase. This is Season 4. Here we are at the Chicagoland Speedway for race number 1 of the chase. 12 drivers, men and women that are involved in the chase, are going to be driving the next 10 races to try to get whatever they can at every point to lead a chance to win the Mountain Race Series Championship here in Season 4. They will be going for every spot because every point does matter. We have had a 1-point separation back in Season 2 where Jake Rogers jumped over Cody Birmingham for the championship. Last season wasn't this close, but 2 out of 3 season finales we've had the championship leader lose the championship in the final race, whoever came in as the points leader. So every point and every position matters here in the Mountain Race Series with its unpredictability as well coming into play. But we're here at Chicagoland Speedway today for the running of the Geico 400, and we are going to go take you to the back to the field. And here is the field. Emilio Navarrete, the rookie who had a hot start to his career when he jumped into this one car, he is on a roll and trying to get his first win. He started in a good spot at position uno. Here he is on the pole. Zach Carlson is on the outside of him in the 21. And then you got Steven Gonzalez in row number 2 on the inside, the highest qualifying chase contender, finished second in the championship last season, who was a strong threat all of last season. He's been up there again this season. He's looking for that elusive first win. He will start in third alongside Mike Becker. Row 3 have teammates from Roush Fenway Racing, Brandon Parsons, who missed out on the chase from a wreck with Cody Lamas at Richmond, took his chances of making it out, so he is just racing for 13th and just for wins. Outside him is Danny Wells, who got in by winning Richmond in a pretty unpredictable way and raced his way into the final spot with the win. He gets to use the bonus points as well. Row 4, you have Aaron Reed, who did not make the chase this season. He's still trying to crawl his way up to about 13th, do whatever he can, and Ryan Juke, who also missed out. And round out your top 10 is another chaser, I should say, Aaron Williams in the 31. He will be starting 9th. Alongside him is Randy Carpenter. There you see James McLeod right there, and Jack Richards and Jacob Rodriguez. But we're going to get the field rolling by, get ready for the command, get this race going underway for 27 laps around Chicagoland Speedway for chase race number 1. We'll see who will survive today and see if the points will be taken out or who will be taken out maybe possibly in the first week. We'll have to wait and see. But racing is coming up next, and your starting grid for the Geico 400 will follow after the command.
Just like I told these boys in the meeting, we don't need anything over the top today. We got a good race car, we got a good driver, we got a good pit crew. All we got to do is just everybody carry the weight.
And again, it never gets to be right, but here's your starting lineup for today's Geico 400, guys. And we are back, guys, and we have controversy to start this race. It happened. We have a lot of cars in the back as a chase contender is sitting on pit road when they start rolling off. The pace car is off. We'll get to that driver in a minute. We got a few cars up to the pack yet. We're going green here in Chicagoland. The chase is on. Emilio Navarrete is going to get the edge on Zach Carlson. And the car that is sitting on pit road, the car did not get going, was Eric Burton. The guy that came here in sole possession of the championship lead. He had a problem before even the chase starts. We don't know what's wrong with him. He did not go. He stopped. They started rolling. He started going. And he just didn't continue on. This little pack back here, they actually all caught up, actually. Some three-wide will happen here. You see him at the front. Danny Wells poked up. And Emilio Navarrete will lead lap 1. Steven Gonzalez, who was starting 3rd, the highest qualifying chaser, did not get a good start. He got kicked to the high side already. And we got a battle for the lead. Zach Carlson to the inside. Emilio Navarrete. The Motorcraft Ford will take the lead. Emiliano Navarro is trying to get a side draft off the 21 car out of the Wood Brothers stable by the one car team, but still. And Zach Carlson is clear completely, and he will now take sole possession of the lead. And there is Eric Burden. He's finally leaving his pit stall. He's already going to be two laps down, almost three. By the time he gets back on the track, he's going to have to hope for a lot of other drivers to have problems, or he's going to have a bad way to start the chase. He will definitely not be the points leader if it continues like this either. But he is two laps down right now in dead last. Go back here a little bit and see what's going on. Seth Collins back here in 30th place. He did not qualify well. He's only gained one spot since the start. There's Sean Henley. He started 29th, I believe. He's about the same spot. He had a horrible qualifying effort as well. Red Bell is right there. More chasers. There's Trent Dunham, but a lot of them qualified near the front. There's Jack Richards, Ryan Acosta, Jacob Rodriguez, James McLeod. There's Eric Williams, Danny Wells, Steve Gonzalez. I know I definitely missed a few, it feels like. Maybe I didn't. I guess I don't know. There's Eric Burden. He is on the back straightaway. The leaders are nowhere near him. He's up to speed, but he is two laps down. And he definitely will need some help to catch back up, as it has been pretty much clean racing. Struggled a lot this track to kind of get it calmed down for the wreck fest. The first couple times I attempted to do this race, I had to stop both times. Another track crashed every time I loaded up, so maybe finally found a good race for you guys to win the wreck fest, and had saved myself from a heart ache and everything too. It looks like the field's starting to get a little more single file near the front. We got a battle for the lead heating up. Emiliano Navarro dies under Zach Carlson for the lead. Brandon Parsons going for it. Oh, Emiliano Navarro got a horrible run on the bottom. That was very unusual right there. I don't know what happened to the one car. But he gave all that momentum away and actually allowed Zach Carlson to pull back away. And on track forward. Brandon Parsons in the Best Buy number 99 is in third place right now, with Mike Becker behind him in fourth. Couple of drivers that just missed out on the chase. Becker actually came into Richmond 10th in the standings and ended up falling out of it and did not get a wild card spot. So Becker did not make the chase, along with Brandon Parsons, who just was trying to get into the top 10 with no wins. It really cost him. And you see Steven Gonzalez back here in 5th. We got a battle for 6th. Randy Carpenter's under mid contender Danny Wells. Aaron Williams, James McLeod, and Aaron Reed are going at it. Oh, Aaron Williams did not get off the corner that well at all. He's going to relinquish that spot to Aaron Reed. Or actually give it back, I guess. Go back a little bit. They are calmed down a lot compared to what they were. Got cars battling right now. Nice solid racing. It looks like Danny Wells going back after Randy Carpenter for the 6th spot. We're under 20 laps to go. And believe me, guys, if you think this race is boring, you should have saw the wreck fest I had to see. So this is not nearly as bad as what it was going to be. I didn't think it was at all good with the team having a real wreck within 5 laps. But anyway, continue on up here through the field. And Emiliano Navarro had the run again, just could not get the bite off the corner. And Carlson pulls back away. I don't know what's wrong with that one car. Apparently he runs better on the high side, but Emilio definitely not probably happy on the radio to his team. He cannot get anything going. See, he's arcing a little bit higher in the corner and dominating it. Oh, he slowed down again. Something's wrong with the one car. Oh, goodness. What in the world? He's slowing down the whole field. What is going on? He's causing a wreck back there. Oh, and Jacob Rodriguez got in a wreck. The one car, something is broke on the one car and caused a huge melee of wrecks behind him. Jacob Rodriguez is upside down, one of the chase contenders. Dylan Young's and there's Cody Lamas, and they're still wrecking. Huge crash. Dylan Pote is barrel rolling. James Qualls in, Zell Harmon, Taylor Orndorff, Darrell Parsons, Michael Houston. There's Seth Cole, he is in trouble. Jack Richards, Adrian Becker, and Matt Wells. Randy Carpenter, he was running good. Cody Lamas is teleporting to pit road. Connor Breeden has damage. There's Dylan Pote again. Wow, I don't even know what happened. Eric Burden's going to get a lot of points. We don't run the back of James Qualls. Well, that was dumb. Here's Ralph Green. Everything's running good in this race, and then Emiliano Navarro broke something, and that was it. I don't even know where the one car is at. Jacob Rodriguez flipped over, and he's back on the track. What is he doing? Seth Cole is doing the same. There's Dougie Hughes. I didn't know he was in the wreck. I'm still looking for the one car. Ooh, these cars are slow in the apron. Three car driver, back around to the pits. Where's Emilio Navarrete? Did he drop out already? I do not know where the one car is at. What caused this wreck? He's not gonna have a lot of people happy with him. There he is. I don't know. We thought something was just, he's just not getting through the corner well enough, but Emilio Navarrete, something broke, and he's still up in front of the whole field. He is out of the race. He probably wants to hurry and get out of here because there's going to be a lot of people angry with him, and a lot of chasers got taken out in that wreck. Let's go back and check that out. We got cars. Still see smoke. Are there cars still on the track? Jacob Rodriguez will not get off the track with a smoking car. What in the world is that? I really don't know what is going on right now and why the 33 car will not get off the track. It really caused Zach Carlson to take the lead. Carlson is trying to get back up to speed. That 33 car is not going to pit road. He's back on the track again. What in the world? He flipped over. I don't know if he went brain dead or something, but Jacob Rodriguez is just driving on the track like nothing's wrong. Wow. I don't even know if I've ever seen that before. He flipped over and just continues to drive on the track. I guess every point matters, but you'd think the crew chief would tell him to get off the track. Oh, he about wrecked brother Matt. I don't know what is going on. Oh, there goes the smoke, and Jacob Rodriguez trying to just gain as many points he can, I guess. But I guess he got black flagged, or, well, the engine just let go. He needs to get off the track, though. Oh, my goodness. Here comes some cars. Darrell Parsons, Ralph Green. You know, watch out. This is not good. Oh, look out. He needs to get off the track. There's Ryan Acosta. Wait, where's that Carlson? Oh, there's that car. Jacob Rodriguez got off the track. He's coasting around. Jacob Rodriguez did jump 30 seconds with 26. Man, get off the track. The officials have to be getting under the 33 car for staying on the track. He's coasting. I don't even know what to say. I was going to go back to the replay, but don't even know what to say. I'm just worried somebody's going to hit him. He's going to stop in the middle of the track. What's going to happen? I don't think I've ever seen an act like this before, ever, in a race. This is almost as bad as driving backwards. Okay, it's nowhere near that, but still. There's the leaders like, oh my goodness, look out. Everybody's trying to get single file. They are aware. Oh, Justin Warren, you don't fall down the line. I don't even know. We've been following this for about 3 laps. If anything happens, we'll go back to that. But we need to go back up to the field. And Zach Carlson lost his lead. Actually going around Ralph Green, who's off the pace. His teammate Aaron Reed, he's getting held up. They're still slow right there. Zach Carlson trying to get on Darrell Parsons, put him a lap down. It's Jacob Rodriguez. He's going to be stopped on the track. He's on the apron. He just refuses to stop. I don't believe this. Oh, my goodness. Look out. Now, it's 33. It's finally off. He is still coasting. I don't believe this. But we had a lot of cars taken out. We're going to go back and show the replay of this wreck. And Zach Carlson is race leader as we're under 10 laps to go. Took out a lot of chases, including Jacob Rodriguez, who still coasting. Okay, very interesting scenario that happened. Emilio Navarrete running second place. Looked like he was going to make a run back at Zach Carlson. We saw him slowing down. As you watch the speed here, look at his speed up here. There it goes. It starts dropping. And he holds up the whole entire field. Zach Carlson is setting sail. Behind him, look at this. Back up. I mean, none of the cars know what to do. Yeah, I wish we could get a better angle. And then you see Cody Lamas back there. He got turned. Everybody has to avoid. I think everybody started running over each other. Cody Lamas actually ran in the back of Jacob Rodriguez. Randy Carpenter about turned Steven Gonzalez right there. Lamas gets ran over by Liam Ervig. That sends Jacob Rodriguez up in the wall. Ryan Acosta sneaks by. Jacob Rodriguez trying to still get out of the way. Callum Wells, just an innocent victim. Ooh. He completely clobbers the 33 car. They go spinning. Trent Dunham barely escaped. The two Evernham cars, Michael Causey and Dylan Young, got in it. They're in it. They're going and hitting the wall. Jacob Rodriguez is getting pushed over by Cody Lamas. He's riding around in his hood. He continues on. And then up here, not quite sure. Oh, Callum Wells, he got ran over by Jack Richards. Callum Wells was not off the track, though, which he should have. He gets hit by Jack Richards here, and this would cause the second wreck. So a lack of drivers having the heads not in the rear apparently was what caused all this. Emiliano Navarro did not get off the track when he slowed down, and Colin Wells pulled back up on the track. Some of the drivers sneak by. Red Bell, we saw, there goes Dylan Pote, he gets hit. Emiliano Navarro is back there again. Sean Hindley is on the apron. You didn't see him right there. There he goes with Barney Ward. Seth Coles in the middle of it. There's Qualls. Richards is in it with Randy Carpenter, his teammate. And they're all wrecking right here. And Dylan Pote goes for a tumble. The Pepsi Max Chevrolet. Not much for a good season for Dylan anyway. And he ended up flipping a few times. But we saw Jacob Rodriguez, Seth Cole, Jack Richards get involved in this wreck. And they are all chase contenders. Eric Burden, we saw how he's already had his issues. A lot of drivers were taken out here early, and then we saw the 33 car start driving off after his wreck. Don't know what all that was about. He already started going, but that went on for a few laps, but nothing happened. Well, now we take you back to the live action as Zach Carlson is still your race leader. And we are back from the crazy mayhem we just saw as Zach Carlson is still your race leader. Look who's made his way up to second. Where did he come from? Ryan Acosta has done this all season long. Just came out of nowhere. And he's now running second place in the Miller Lite Dodge. Maybe he senses now that in real life Brad Keselowski won the championship in the two car. He thinks he can do it. The car has won the championship in my series before. Season 2 with Jake Rogers won by 1 point. Ryan Acosta wants to get his first win. He's in the chase. He's in a good spot right now also. Running in the highest chase position. And they're running down Zach Carlson with Aaron Reed back here in third. Aaron Williams now up to fourth. This is huge for him. Danny Wells as well in fifth. Wells. There's Rodriguez. He's sitting on pit row. I don't know if that was a very, very wrong move for him to go on the track and put a lot of drivers good days in danger or their safety. James McLeod's in sixth right now. He needed this. Ryan Duke. There's Trent Dunham in eighth. Brody Vanta in ninth. And Brandon Parsons running 10th. Looking for more chasers. There's Steven Gonzalez. He just dropped back to the 14th position. That 22 car just not been at all here today at Chicagoland. He had a good qualifying effort. Started third, but just doesn't got it today. And we got a battle up here for the lead. Heating up. Aaron Reed had a look under Ryan Acosta, who just slingshot under Zach Carlson for the lead. Here comes Ryan Acosta in the Miller Lite Dodge. Man, he just slingshot around Zach Carlson. Carlson's going to try to drive it hard on the high side. And he has a huge run. But can he do anything with it? They're going to drag race the line. It looks like he's going to keep Acosta from leading the lap. He does, and he's going to get the lead back. They're catching up to Adrian Becker, who is slow. It's going to depend where she goes. Zach Carlson's got to be careful. He's going to get boxed in there. He's not going to let it happen. Going to dive under the 42. Aaron Williams going for third. Aaron Reed needs to try to stay in line so he doesn't lose any more spots. Trent Dunham has Brody Vanta all over him. We're going to go back a little bit and see more chasers are still in the race. Red Bell's back in 18th. Sean Hindley is in 20th. And that's it. Here are the drivers that got knocked out of the race. Eric Burton, actually, when he wrecked, he was two laps down. He did not gain any position. So Eric Burton came in here as a points leader by 3 points. Is no longer in this race. He's going to finish dead last today. He had 2009 points. Everybody with one win that was in the top 10 had 2006 or 2003 points. No, he had 2006 points. Fail. The other drivers had 2003 points, and then Acosta is one of them. Hell, he had 2000 with his teammate Steven Gonzalez, and then the two wildcard drivers had 2000. So it was only separated by 6 points from first to 12th, and a lot of them got taken out early. Eric Burton's in 42nd. And then Seth Cole ended up 33rd, Jack Richards 31st. He is the defending winner of this race, and he finished 31st, so this is not going to help our defending champion here at all. And then you see in 26th place, even though he shouldn't have got those positions, was Jacob Rodriguez. He might end up actually getting penalized a couple of laps and dropped back to where he was supposed to be, because he should have been driving the track with a smoking car. So we'll have to review that. The officials will all be reviewing what's going to happen there. And we have two laps to go. Every other chaser is still in the race. It's Brian Acosta and Zach Carlson have pulled away from Aaron Reed and Danny Wells. Danny actually just got around Aaron Williams for fourth. McLeod's going after him for fifth. But does Ryan Acosta have anything for Zach Carlson, who's been the show today here in Chicagoland? The white flag is out. One lap to go for these two drivers. Carlson looking for his second win of the season. A former Daytona 500 winner, and he has won at Talladega. And he won earlier in the season at Pocono, looking for his fourth career win. Ryan Acosta looking for win number one. He's on the back bumper of the 21. Does Ryan Acosta have anything for the 21 car of Zach Carlson? Acosta trying to build the run, but can he dive bomb in the corner? Carlson is taking his line. Acosta is still on the bumper, but does he have time? He's going to run out of time, it looks like. Zach Carlson is going to come in here, dominate the Geico 400, and wins here in Chicagoland. And a great run for Zach Carlson in this 21 team. Just missed out on the chase. He definitely wished he was in the chase this season, but a momentum builder for this team, morale builder, and hopefully build some confidence in this young driver that's driving the famous 21. Zach Carlson picked up his second win of the season, his fourth of his career, building a name for himself right here in the series, getting these wins. Big win for him. Congrats to him. Ryan Acosta ended up second today. He could be your new points leader as well. So the quiet guy, the guy in the chase, didn't hear much about him. Making some noise here at the start of the chase, making a big statement there with that second place finish. He will have a great points day today. Aaron Reed will finish third. Good run for him. Danny Wells, Aaron Williams, James McLeod, 4th through 6th. All chasers. Big time run for them. Ryan Juke will end up 7th. Trent Dunham, another chaser. He will finish 8th in car number 8. Brody Banta and Brandon Parsons round out your top 10. Then you got Sean Galligan, Tim Fralick, Steven Gonzalez will end up 13th. Jessica Lawrence, Liam Ervig, Mike Becker, Jessica Miller, Red Bell, 18th. Barney Ward, Sean Henley will end up 20th. Then you got Matthew Rodriguez and Charles Jackson, 21st, 22nd, last cars in the lead lap. Darrell Parsons, Ralph Green with a lap down. Adrian Becker was 4 laps down. And then the drivers that were multiple laps down. And again, Jacob Rodriguez might end up being penalized a couple of laps. And he probably will drop back down to the 30s. So it's not really official where he is going to be at. That or he might get a point deduction for what he did staying on the track and putting the drivers in danger for about 3 laps. He was driving, trying to drive full speed, which was definitely unnecessary. I'm going to export this before I talk about all this and forget about it. Race 27 is now in the books. And you look through the field, the drivers got taken out today. You see Jacob Rodriguez with a broken camshaft. Surprisingly, finished where he did. Taylor Orndorff, Jack Richards. Bad day for him. He'll end up 28th. Matt Wells, Dougie Shears, Randy Carpenter, Connor Breen, Callum Wells, Emilio Navarro. And some of these drivers actually, I guess, gained some spots. I just noticed because some of these guys went down. Dylan Poteet. And then you see Emilio Navarro, like I said, he was had the issue right in front of all the field but Zach Carlson. Seth Cole ended up 36th place today. Zohar Mutton, James Qualls, Cody Lamas, Dylan Young, Michael Causey, and Eric Burden. Points that are coming in definitely won't be leaving points leader. He ended up dead last today in the 40. There's your results from today's race. And probably in the description, if something happens, a penalty will be given out to the 33 car of Jacob Rodriguez, which is going to hurt him a lot. But that will be given out at the end of this video. Will be pointed out or something like that, or in the description, something. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed today's race, and I will show you guys what we're going for the next race. Go to the post-race screen, and that'll be it for here, Chicagoland. So congrats to Zach Carlson, and here comes the post-race. Alrighty, so we are done here from Chicagoland. First chase race is done. 9 races left in the chase, and the points have already been shuffled up big time. Some drivers are going to be playing catch-up early in this chase. Probably didn't want to, but circumstances didn't go their way today. Drivers like Eric Burden, Seth Cole, Jack Richards, and others are going to have to try to make a comeback now. As we head off to our next race, the Sylvania 300 will be our next race, and that will be taking place at Loudoun, New Hampshire, which should be interesting if we go there for our next race. We'll see what happens there, as we'll take you now, hopefully, to a good race again. Hopefully we'll have a wreck fest or nothing. Shouldn't be that bad. New Hampshire's not known for having wrecks like crazy, even though we did earlier this season, but shouldn't be as bad. But I'll see you guys there for the Sylvania 300. Thanks for watching the chase race number 1 here in the Mountain Race Series, and I hope to see you guys again for the New Hampshire race and the rest of the chase here as Season 4 winds down and a champion will be crowned soon. Stay tuned to this and the Mopar Nationwide Series championship hunt as well as they're battling as hard as they are in the Cup Series. So thanks again, Zach Carlson, congrats on the win. And I'll see you guys next time, and make sure not to spoil, guys. Always a plus when you guys don't do that. So thanks again, and I'll see you guys soon.